doing. That's so thirsty. It's like when you have nothing better to offer. Clippers should be better than that.
No, no, these are not. But did the Clippers do this?
Yeah.
They said that the Clippers related hashtags. The Clippers said they knew nothing about it.
Right. They claim they knew nothing about it. But stop. Just stop. The point is, I'm not talking about the Clippers. I mean, Clippers fans, L.A., knock it off.
Got it.
You sell, L.A. should sell itself. It's his home and everything. I'm going to leave that to you. In terms of what makes Kawhi happy, that's what he should do. And in terms of returning home or anything else, Stephen A., if you want to talk about that, I'll leave that to you. Because I want to talk about Kawhi Leonard's legacy. Kawhi got a little bit of a slow start in his career compared to other players who have reached the peaks that he has reached, the heights that he has reached, and we don't even know if he's finished. Maybe he'll get better than this, because in these last playoffs, that's the best he's ever been. But mostly guys who get that good start with more ballyhooed coming out of the amateurs, right? Whether that's college or overseas or wherever, they're well known. There's this whole kind of groundswell of support for the idea that this could be the next big thing. That wasn't Kawhi. He's had to build himself there. And because of that, people like Stephen A. Smith, if I say Kawhi's the best player in the world, he'll go back and say, KD's been doing it for X number of years. Kawhi just got here, but he won an MVP, finals MVP with the Spurs. Yeah, but he was a baby when he did that. That was for his defense. He averaged 14 points. He only started averaging 20 toward the end of that series. He had help, etc. Now he gets credit for this last finals win. And even then, well, KD was hurt and all this stuff. But you know what Kawhi has done, guys? He's won the MVP of the finals with two different teams. The only other players to do that in the history of basketball. LeBron James and Kareem Abdul-Jabbar. Mm-hmm. That's it. Stephen A., I'm saying for his legacy, he goes to the Clippers.
Mm-hmm.
If he goes to the Clippers, it is my contention that the Clippers will win the championship this upcoming season. He will be the MVP. He will be the first man ever to win three separate finals MVP awards with three separate teams. For his legacy, forget about his own happiness for a second, I'll leave that to you. For his legacy, it is the strongest possible move.
You can say for his legacy, listen, it was beautiful being in Toronto, Canada. It's a beautiful city, there's no question about it. The National Basketball Association's NBA champion is a team from Canada. You know, it was nice watching them during the finals. But now that the offseason has arrived, nobody's really thinking about them that much. You think about Kawhi, you're not thinking about them. And I don't know if there's anything that Kawhi could do to change that. It would be wise for them to do everything that they possibly can to keep themselves, to make sure that they have him. But in the end, what it really, really comes down to is this. When you talk about L.A., first of all, L.A. is lovely. I've just fallen more and more in love with it every single day. But, you know, and I definitely have my own individual aspirations for L.A. I am unapologetic about that. Having said all of that, though, it's not just that it's where Kawhi was born and raised before electing to go 2 hours away to San Diego State and, you know, having a home, you know, north of there, whatever. It's also the fact that LeBron is in L.A. You want to talk about the eye of the basketball world descending upon one place? Could you imagine if Kawhi is on one team and LeBron is on another in the same arena? In the same arena. And by the way, now LeBron has Anthony Davis, so you know that the Lakers are going to contend. The Los Angeles Clippers last year won 48 games. This is not a scrub team, for crying out loud. You're not talking about having to get rid of anybody in order to acquire Kawhi. So if Kawhi is there, I got my man Max Kellerman here talking about how they gonna win a title in LA for a Clippers franchise that has never even been to a conference finals. They got the richest owner in the sport. They've got a Hall of Fame coach, as far as I'm concerned, in Doc Rivers, who's a champion. They have the greatest executive in the history of the sport as having the ear and being the right-hand man of the richest owner in sports. And oh, by the way, your supplementary parts of guys like Lawrence Frank and others who work diligently, know the game of basketball. They're a first-class organization from top to bottom, okay? So when you look at the Los Angeles Clippers, adding Kawhi in Southern California with LeBron in the same city, in the same arena, competing against you, excuse me, you talk about not just them as an organization, but the sport of basketball, the National Basketball Association, being in the mind's eye of everyone, including folks in Canada. I mean, come on now. I don't think anything beats that. Kawhi went to Canada. He did what he came to do. He accomplished his goal. You know what? If Masai stays, it's possible Kawhi may elect to stay. He's definitely going if Masai is going, for what I'm being told. But if I'm Kawhi, L.A., it's L.A.
Look at those numbers. I love that, Stephen A. Look at those numbers. Yeah. It's a dead heat. I mean, LeBron more of an assist guy. The PER slightly favors Kawhi. That counts everything on offense. But defense, it's not close. Kawhi is light years better than LeBron and more consistent than LeBron defensively. And then add the playoffs where LeBron didn't play and Kawhi just had one of the great postseasons of all time. Think about what you just said about L.A. Either the Clippers get home games or the Lakers do. Basically every day of the year, you got something going on. It's jumping off at Staples Center. That's a great reason for him to go to L.A. But I'm telling you right now, imagine that Kawhi in the same town with LeBron. And I'm telling you right now, this will happen. His team gets farther than, because I think they'll win the championship, the LeBron AD team on the Lakers. For the first time, they not only get to the conference finals, but they win. That town will never flip Clippers the way I believe this town could flip Nets over Knicks. But temporarily, it could be Clippers, and Kawhi could be responsible for that. He will have finally addressed the issue, which is the kind of ascension of his career being a slow build.
Okay.
And if he wins a championship there, he'll be elevated to the upper echelon of all-time greats in a way he's not now. Stephen A., also, he won the chip in Toronto. That's a kind of a gangster move. You show up 1 year, win the chip, and you're out. That doesn't look bad for Kawhi. He delivered.
He delivered. There's nothing more he can do in Toronto. See, and people are not really thinking about that. What are you staying in Toronto for? The nation, the country of Canada loves you. Okay, granted. They love you. They can't love you any more than they already do. There's nowhere to go.
Unless he feels like he has a better shot staying in Toronto to win than joining the Clippers.
And I don't see how, as great as Masai is, and the road to prosperity is easier through the East. Mm-hmm. I get all of that. The flip side to it is that I look at Southern California. That's his home, for crying out loud. So we want to go. We ain't from there. This man is from there. His loved ones, his inner circle, his close ones are all there. And you have an opportunity to go to L.A. and compete for championships and be in the eye of the storm directly up against LeBron James. That would be beautiful.
No brainer for you. All right, let's leave it on that note, guys. Much more debate to come here on First Take. Who should win the NBA MVP award tonight? Giannis, Harden, or Paul George? I got a feeling we got some disagreement.